That's my dog right there. When he start getting going, you can hear that country come out a little bit. Join us right now is a man who led the league in interceptions the same year he went to the Pro Bowl. You saw him anchor secondaries for the Lions and the Texans. He is now enjoying that retirement life. Please welcome to the breakfast table, woo-hoo, my man, Glover Quinn.
What's up, man?
What's up, Glover?
GQ, what's poppin', baby? Now, GQ, you played 10 years in the league. And you retired, you shut it down, you got a big smile on your face. How are you enjoying retirement life? What are you up to?
Man, I'm happy, man. I'm home every day. I'm enjoying my kids, wife, man. I'm getting into videography, man. So I record all types of stuff. And I'm editing videos and taking classes and all types of stuff, man. So it's fun, man. It's finally getting a chance to like sit back and like take a break from like football and kind of connect to a different side of life that, you know, for so many years I just kind of neglected because I was so focused on like football and trying to, you know, survive and be the best that I can be. And so now I get to sit back and like just take in so much time and kind of slow down and decompress, man. So it's been good.
You awesome. Look happy.
Yeah.
You look
very
really happy. We love having you here on the show. I heard a rumor that you were in the broadcast booth for preseason.
I was.
The Lions. I want to hear all about that. I need to know what the perspective was like being back with the Lions, but in a different way.
It was kind of weird because I played for the Texans. I started with Houston, and then I finished up in Detroit. And, you know, great respect for both organizations. But just seeing the game from, like, way up there was different. And then talking about it, you know, it was kind of hard for me, too, because trying to follow the ball and, like, because when you're on the field, you're so used to seeing the game a certain way. And so now when I'm up there and I'm looking, I'm just like, and I'm looking at certain friends and I'm looking at this. And I'm just like, oh, what happened? Like, it was a little weird at first. But,
is something you'd want to do?
That is the most difficult thing that I've ever done. Is calling a game.
It was the hardest thing. It was hard. Yeah. But it was cool. You know, it was different. It was fun. Yeah. Seeing the game from up there. But you know, I kind of like.
You like videography?
Yeah. I like videography.
When you played in this league, you played in 159 of 160 possible games. Your whole thing was durability, leadership, veteran presence, and you could always make the big play. If a team calls you right now and says, hey, Glover, we need 4 more weeks. We're going into the playoffs. We need that. Would you be willing to listen to that call?
Nah, I'm done, man.
Yeah?
I'm done, man.
That's it?
I'm done.
Oh, hey, but your vet minimum is like 70K a week,
I'm done,
bro.
See the smile on his face? He's happy.
I love videography and all, but.
Yeah.
To turn done, down 70K man. A week, that man is enjoying himself.
All right, something was captured on video this past week, and it was the Houston Texans running right through the Patriots, all right? You're a former Texan. Uh-huh. I know you still watch the game. You're into the game. We've been waiting on Houston to make the jump. Mm-hmm. They just beat New England. Does this team, I mean, could this Houston team go to the Super Bowl this year?
I've been thinking once you get in the playoffs, anything is possible. I mean, they got some dynamic playmakers, obviously Deshaun Watson, DeAndre Hopkins doing their thing. It'll be tough coming out of the AFC. You know, the Ravens are looking well. You know, the Patriots are going to be tough. You know, it's tough to beat those guys in the playoffs. But playing down there on Sunday night is a great atmosphere. You know, those guys came out to play, and they won. They did what they had to do. But it'll be tough to beat them again in the playoffs and get past the Ravens. So hopefully they can make it. It'll be great for the city, but we'll see.
Speaking of great for the city, let's talk about the Detroit Lions. 3-8-1 right now. Struggle bus is real.
It's not looking good.
What do you think about the Lions? And just keep it real. Do you think that Patricia is the man for the job that can get him out the gutter?
You know, I think the Lions are in a tough spot right now. I just don't think they're playing well. I mean, they're losing a lot of close games. You know, they've been winning in all these games.
Right.
And they're losing. Defensively, they're not making the big plays to win the games. You know, and Patricia was bought in to be a defensive coach. And, you know, they haven't. You know,
got to get that right.
You know, I think they got some decisions that they got to make. You know, it's tough right now, and they're dealing with a bunch of injuries, and you know, it's tough.
Yeah.
You know, do I think Patricia is the guy? You know, that's not my decision.
Yeah.
You know,
they fired a playoff coach.
Right.
He hasn't made the playoffs.
Right. And that was the thing. You know, they said 9-7 wasn't good enough, and in this league, there's a lot of teams that. You know, would love to be 9-7, have a shot to make the playoffs.
That's facts.
So, You know, being that I think they've won 9 games in the last 2 years.
Mm-hmm. So time will tell is what you're saying.
Right. And so, you know, we'll see.
GQ.
Hey, well, GQ, we appreciate you joining us, man. Thank you so much. Come back anytime, man.
Anytime.
You know what I'm saying? And you can record a video for us if you want to be behind the camera, too.
You had production meetings?
Oh, man. This was GQ? One of the best guys to have in a production meeting. He anchored the defense and would tell you exactly what
quarterback on defense. Absolutely. The smartest minds in the game.
Love having you here on the show.
GQ, appreciate you, man. I'll talk to you guys.
Was he the present?
The present?
I don't know. I heard you have an early Christmas gift.
An early Christmas gift?
That's what I hear.
I do. I have some shoes for my calls, my cleats, Kat.
Work with me here.
Oh,
work
I got you. Here. I got you.
Bills Ravens this weekend. Who will we be talking about on Monday?